Hello, it's February 11th, 2009. I'm Reginald, also known as Demcat. First, the stimulus package. It passed through some levels, and they're going to get a final vote. Looks like it's going to be $789 billion. Majority Leader Harry Reid is saying that this is going to create 3.5 million jobs. Jim Owens, CEO of Caterpillar, is claiming that he's going to rehire some laid-off workers because of the stimulus package. Well, one, it's just some workers, not all of them. And two, for how long will they be hired? I don't know. Part of the stimulus package will include Barack Obama's Making Work Pay, his Making Work Pay program. This is going to affect 95% of workers. It's going to be a tax credit. It means that you're going to receive an additional $13 every week in your paycheck. So you can look for an extra $13 in your paycheck. And that's supposed to also help the economy. Israel. Netanyahu, his party won 27 seats. The center-left party won 28 seats. But since the right-wing parties won more seats than the left-wing parties, they're probably going to have a right-wing government. And that's how things work in a parliamentary system. The government, the parties come together and they form a coalition. I don't know if it's going to be that stable, but we'll see. Two judges in Pennsylvania are being accused of accepting money to put kids away. Basically, they're being accused of accepting $2.6 million in payoffs from the Pennsylvania Child Care LLC and their sister company to basically give them favor in their decision. So they would actually profit off this. So that's how it worked. One girl, Hillary Transue, was sentenced to a wilderness camp after she made a MySpace page that made fun of her her assistant principal. It was sort of like a spoof page. Hi, I'm Dick, and my activities include, well, you get the point. Apparently, she didn't even know she had a right to get an attorney. She didn't get an attorney, and she didn't even know she had a right. This is crazy. This is one of the things that really shakes my confidence in the criminal justice system. I mean, come on. Anyway, Amanda Gessner, 19-year-old pregnant, she went on a crime spree. She set about 7 fires between 3:05 and 5:45 in the morning. So in the middle of the night and early in the morning, she just set fires all over the place. Apparently, she was caught on video at one of those surveillance stores, all the convenience stores. She was caught on a surveillance camera, and she was singing about how the firefighters are going to be mad at her, and she was singing. Yeah, she took pictures apparently, and she enjoyed seeing the fire trucks and the fire engines arrive. Anyway, speaking of teenagers, according to Cyber Sentinel, that's a UK site, teenagers spend an average of 31 hours on the internet. Okay, this includes 3.5 hours on MSN, 2 hours looking at porn, only 2 hours. Anyway, 2 hours on YouTube and in chat rooms. Not a surprise there, but 31 is kind of extreme. I mean, I don't know, maybe I spend 31 hours on the internet, but that's a lot. I mean, it's like almost like a full-time job, you know? Anyway, baseball great. Apparently this guy was a baseball great. I'm not a fan of baseball, but Roberto Alomar has been hit with a lawsuit. His ex-girlfriend claims that he had full-blown AIDS, and he insisted on having unprotected sex with her, and he didn't let her know. And when she found out, she stopped having sex with him, and she got tested, and she was negative. So he's been hit with a $15 million lawsuit because of that. Wow. Apparently, I don't know what to say. I don't even know if that's true or not. A zoo in Battle Creek, Michigan, Binder Park Zoo, they're going to charge $50 for people to watch animals have sex. I'm not making that up. It's a Valentine's date. That's their idea for Valentine's. I wonder what happened in the room when the director said, okay, we're gonna, revenue's down. I'm going to need all the ideas I can get. We got to think outside the box. And someone says, you know, why don't we have a Valentine's Day event where animals have sex with one another? Anyway, I know what some of you guys are thinking. Why isn't he talking about the economy, the economy, the economy? Okay, here's something to think about. Economists are lowering their expectations for the fourth quarter. Apparently, the gross domestic product was, the decline was a lot higher than was originally reported in the preliminary reports. The preliminary report said it was 3.8%, 3.8% decline. Now, some economists are saying it's going to be more like 4.6 or even 5% decline. I don't know what the exact definition of depression. I think it's a 10% contraction in the gross domestic product, but if we really did lose 5%, I don't think things are going to get a lot better anytime soon, so I don't think it's inappropriate to use the D word.